Welcome to the International Journal of Operation and Production Management podcast series, where we explore the latest research, ideas, and trends in the world of operation and production management. Speaking today are your hosts, Andrea and Osnur, as part of the social media team at IJOPM. In each episode, we'll be speaking with experts from academia, industries, and beyond to gain their insights on the most pressing issues facing operation and production management professional today, as well as best practices to publish your research is one of the leading journals in the field.
In the second episode, we'll be discussing and gaining a deeper understanding of circular economy research in the context of supply chain and operations management, as well as its possible developments. To do that, we will be speaking with Dr. Luciana Battista, who has guest edited the special issue titled Applying Operations and Supply Chain Management Theories in the Circular Economy Context. It was published in the International Journal of Operations and Production Management, issue 4 of this year.
Thank you so much for your time and presence today, Luciano. Could you please introduce yourself to our audience?
Yes, thank you for having me first, and it's a pleasure to be here and to talk about our special issue for the International Journal of Operations and Production Management. My research at Aston University is based on circular economy and sustainable supply chain systems. So I'm an academic from Aston Business School, where I'm based. I'm a senior lecturer in operations and supply chain management. I'm also director of the Center for Circular Economy and Advanced Sustainability, where we developed a sustainability-oriented research. And my main focus is to contextualize operations and supply chain management in the circular economy.
All right, time to deep dive into the topic of this podcast. Luciano, we are unsure whether the concepts of circular economy is fully understood in the context of supply chain management and operations management in particular. So we know that it has growing popularity, though. Could you please remind both scholars and practitioners listening to the podcast what we mean by circular economy in this context and in supply chain across industries?
Okay, circular economy is a sustainability-oriented paradigm for production and consumption systems in the economy. It is mainly underpinned by three fundamental principles. The first one is the elimination of waste and pollution. The second one is the circularization of products and materials. By circularization, we mean to keep products in the economy at their highest value for as long as possible. And the third one is the regeneration of energy and materials. In that sense, circular economy production systems should look at using renewable sources of energy. So that's the best way to understand circular economy in general terms. Of course, to implement these principles, these sustainability-oriented principles, it is important to redesign a number of products that we have in the circular economy at the moment. Redesign the processes for production of these products as well, and also to rethink the way we use energy systems. Try to replace energy systems based in fossil fuels and non-renewable sources to renewable sources of energy, like wind, solar energy, and other alternatives we have out there being developed.
Thank you so much for shedding light on these important aspects. So given this growing popularity in both research and practice, we'd like to hear your thoughts on the following question. Do you believe that the pace of development of circular economy principle and practices has been parallel in both industry and academia?
That's an interesting question. The academia is actually lagging a bit behind from industry in terms of implementing circular economy systems, production and consumption systems. What I'm saying that industry is being quite innovative in the way that they are very active in trying to replace non-sustainable systems to more sustainable systems for a number of reasons. First, pressure from governments that are establishing net zero targets, and the companies they are trying to meet those targets by becoming more sustainable in that way, looking for implementing circular economy practices based on the principles that I have mentioned in the first part. And the second one is the pressure from consumers. Consumers are valuing more, the sustainability products, and buying products from companies that are sustainable. They are becoming more aware of the problems of pollution in the oceans and air pollution as well. So they are trying to get engaged with companies that are more sustainable, including investors themselves. More and more investors are valuing companies that are based on sustainability principles, that implement sustainability principles. And the companies themselves, they are looking for becoming more sustainable because of the scarcity of resources. We know that the resources we have, particularly the non-renewable ones, they are becoming more and more scarce. So if they don't replace that dependence on scarce and non-renewable resources, they'll be in trouble. So industry is quite active in implementing circular economy for those reasons. Of course, academia is also looking at circular economy. The number of publications on circular economy has been growing significantly over the past years. And we can say that some of the researches on circular economy out there are quite interesting, quite innovative. They are generating and providing good insights for industries themselves to improve what they have already started in terms of circular economy implementation. So it's becoming a very critical topic, I think I'd say a very hot topic for organizations in general and also the academia for that reason.
Luciana, thank you so much. These are very useful insights. Looking at the bibliometric analysis you and your co-authors recently published in our journal to introduce a special issue, it appears that circular economy research has flourished in a matter of years. So, what advice would you give to researchers who are currently interested in circular economy issues? This is our first question. The second question is, what are the most promising current and future research topics and opportunities, of course, in your opinion?
Yes, that's an interesting question. Because circular economy is such a wide concept, it's a very broad, it involves many aspects of production and consumption systems from the level of the product, from the level of the supply chain, and from the level of the company. The research on circular economy is quite dispersed and fragmented. So academics tend to look at circular economy from different angles. Of course, from the angles they are expert, or they have an interest in researching. So it's quite diverse. For that reason, it's still problematic to find a common ground for circular economy principles and particularly circular economy theory. There is not such a thing like a well-defined circular economy theory. That is why we have worked on this special issue for the IJOPM. Try to call the academic community to consider the contribution of their research to the circular economy theory. Of course, the practical implications of research for the circular economy is very relevant, but it is also important that researchers, they try to derive some theoretical contributions from their research. And quite commonly, we see many publications and papers out there that highlight the practical implications of their research, but they do not actually address any theoretical implications and do not make any theoretical contributions. I think this is a very important role that this special issue at IJOPM is playing in that context, is filling that gap, try to call the academic community to consider, yeah, in a more focused way, the theoretical contributions of their work for the circular economy. And you also ask about future research topics in that area. There is not a single topic. So any topic that relates to operations, production, and supply chain and logistics systems is important. What is important at the connection between those operations and supply chain management perspective is very clearly made with the circular economy principles in terms of creating circularity of products and creating systems that are based on renewable sources of energy. And it is also important to derive some concepts that help to the design of products, supply chains, and processes that are circular. What I mean by circular is to design products that can be easily recovered at the end of their life. So you can look at it from many different angles. So my message is, whatever the angle of your research, if you are able to make any connection with regenerative systems, with the redesign of products or processes to minimize waste and pollution, redesign of production systems to be less dependent on non-renewable sources of energy. They are all relevant topics. They're all relevant as long as they clearly contribute to the redesign of the current systems we have to more sustainable systems that are based on the circular economy principles. So it's hard to pinpoint a couple of topics. I say the domain of operations and supply chain management in general is important to the circular economy, because we do, as academic researchers working on operations and supply chains, we contribute to the development of production and consumption systems. And in that way, whatever the angle we take on operations and supply chain management, it's important to make that connection in terms of creating circularity, creating systems, production and consumption systems that are based on circular economy principles, the three principles, fundamental principles I mentioned at the beginning.
Thank you so much. This is a very important message, especially to be communicated to authors in this domain. And in relationship to the research design of a circular economy project, what, in your opinion, are the main difficulties or challenges in conducting research in this area, especially in the context of operation supply chain management? And I'm referring, for example, in difficulties or challenges in collecting data, interacting with industry professional, and so on.
Yeah. I think the challenge is not on the side of collecting data. Many researchers they already work with organizations. They have access to data, they can get qualitative data from the industries they have contact with. They also can have access to quantitative data from reports on carbon emission levels and rates. So there is substantial data. I don't think the difficulties rely on access to data. I think the main difficulty for developing research in circular economy is the lack of a common theoretical ground, because you can researchers at the moment are using circular economy as an umbrella term for anything that relates to sustainability. For that reason, lots of confusion is created, and many people think that circular economy is about recycling and overlook the other possibilities of reuse, repair, and other regenerative options that are available for developing circular economy systems. I would say that the most important thing for academics is try to make a contribution to a common ground. That's why we're trying to develop this call, yeah, for the academic community to address the theoretical contributions from their research to the circular economy. I'm just reinforcing what I have said before. But this is quite critical because academics tend to see it or to look at circular economy from different angles. And the lack of a common ground for a circular economy theory creates a difficulty, that is a difficulty of having convergence of concepts, convergence of frameworks that help the further development of the circular economy itself. That's my view, is the fragmented nature of the theoretical takes on the circular economy. But there are some interesting developments in this special issue. I think this special issue has the potential to make a seminal contribution in terms of drawing attention from the academic community and practitioners as well to the importance of having a sustainability dominant logic for the circular economy. And that sustainability dominant logic is that common ground, is a convergence point from where different research streams can converge into and create a theoretical body that will make more sense for the circular economy. Because at the moment, circular economy is based on different schools of thought, from systems thinking, from industrial symbiosis, part of the industrial ecology as well, some principles based on biomimicry and the blue economy, also some principles based on deriving regenerative systems, redesigning systems for regeneration, to lots of publications on waste management. Is substantial the number of research and papers on circular economy that take the waste management angle. But these are just parts. Yeah, they are important parts, but not connected and not converging. Much to the contrary, they tend to evolve in their specific areas and silos, and they're not. We still cannot see an emergence or emergence of a circular economy theory. So that's why we believe that the sustainability dominant logic is going to be very helpful for the future of academic research on circular economy.
Thank you very much, Luciano. Actually, I will be asking a question about about the theories. You partially replied to our question, but I would like to ask our last question once more, if in case you want to add some other aspects that could be critical for our audience. So because we know that many of our journals require research to have solid theoretical foundations, we are still curious about the particular circular economy theories. So could you please tell us which theories have been shown to be more effective in studying analyzing circular economy issues, particularly in operations management and supply chain management?
Yes, there is a clearly a predominant take from operations and supply chain management research on circular economy based on the resource-based view theory, the RBV. Yeah, it makes sense because if you take the resource-based theory to support research on circular economy, it provides a good theoretical basis and a good theoretical framework because it's based on resources and how to make resources more sustainable is the main objective and the main connection between resource-based theory and circular economy. But having said that, limiting circular economy research to the resource-based view is not comprehensive. It does not include the broad aspect of the circular economy. What I'm saying, circular economy is beyond managing resources. It goes to also redesign resources. So it's a wider perspective. So there are lots of theory in terms of sustainable product management theories and redesign of linear systems, the redesigned production systems as a whole and engineering systems. That is quite relevant and the most because the resource-based view is the most popular one at the moment. The evolution of research around circular economy tends to build upon that resource-based view. But what I'm saying is that we should look a bit out of the box. There are other theories out there that are also very helpful, perhaps even more helpful than just the resource-based view of organizations. So, for example, if you consider the remanufacturing systems, remanufacturing is based on a major redesign of production and consumption system based on servitization as well. So servitization is a quite relevant theoretical take on circular economy, because it relates to the dematerialization of the economy. Yeah, it's creating an economy that is more based not on the production of tangible goods or resources, but more in the use, is the replacement of value in ownership to the value in use, and service systems, they provide that, yeah, that change and that theoretical perspective in terms of advanced service systems, servitization. They provide base for all these redesign, the wider perspective of redesign. Circular economy is not just about resources, it's about redesigning systems. And that's why RBV is a bit limited in that sense. Yeah, because as we say, we try to redesign out waste of the economy requires wider perspectives. It's go back to this redesign products from concept thinking about the end of life, and then you have other you have to look for other theoretical bases that help you to consider the wider perspective of your research, not just on the resource element, but also other wider elements that can be involved in the redesign, like redesign of processes, redesign of relationships between buyers and suppliers. So it's much wider than just looking at resource based. So this is what I would like to draw attention from the academic community in that sense. Yeah, look for wider theoretical perspectives.
Thank you so much. We have one more question, and you already touched a little bit about that, but we want to have an answer more explicitly. So this is related to the connection between what is research in theory and what happened in practice. So it is our understanding that industries have different level of maturity in terms of design and development of circular supply chain. Do you think this is true? And if this is the case, what sector do you believe are more mature and when circular economy principle must be implemented the most?
Yeah, certainly. There are lots of innovations on manufacturing systems. Yeah, to the point that remanufacturing is being out there for many years. Yeah. And interestingly, many industries, they develop circular economy systems without actually knowing they are developing circular economy systems. They're trying to develop more sustainable systems and systems that recover those valuable resources from the consumers back to production. That's the remanufacturing element. And that is quite much attached to the services and new service innovations. That's why industry is quite active in that sense. I think the most difficult part is that when you start implementing circular economy systems and redesigning your system to become more sustainable, is how to measure it. Is the metrics? Yeah, how to create measurement systems to measure the performance of your circular economy. So circular economy metrics is a quite important topic emerging in this context, particularly in the context of ESG agenda and the environment, social and governance reporting, and how to develop circular economy metrics is becoming more and more critical for the future of these systems, because you implement the sustainable systems, but then you have to measure the performance of the system over time. You have to have benchmarking references to improve and carry on improving your products and production processes as well. And there are quite a few progress, I would say, in the business models for the circular economy. There are business model innovations for the circular economy because they are based on regenerative systems. They're based, for example, in the sharing economy, in the collaborative consumption. And those systems, by nature and by definition, they are quite much in the core of the circular economy principle of reusing resources. When you have a collaborative consumption system, you are enabling and expanding the possibilities of reusing resources and products for as much as possible. So there are some interesting business model innovations in that sense. Business model for the circular economy, creating circularity, creating circular supply chains based on on recovering, getting back products that are being consumed in the society back to the production and reproducing them, reusing, upcycling those is in a good way. There are lots of initiatives in terms of digital technologies. They play a fundamental role in enabling these regenerative systems, to the sense that circular economy concepts and all these sustainability principles like industrial symbiosis, biomimicry, and all the main industrial ecology elements that underpin circular economy principles, they are not new. They are concepts that are out there. Recycling technology, they are concepts production processes that are in the economy for many decades. So why is circular economy becoming stronger just now, or only now, if you like? It's because we have more technologies available to implement more regenerative systems. We have more digital technologies that facilitate the information sharing, facilitate the recovery of products. And these technology in terms of the materials being evolving, the engineering science of materials, so the novel materials out there. So all these technological innovations, they contributed to a more strong focus on the circular economy at this moment in time. So it's important that for the academic community to consider all those different nuances and aspects in terms of business model innovations, how to use digital technologies to facilitate the implementation of circular economy systems. When I say circular economy systems, it's systems based on those three principles of the circular economy. And I think the redesign is quite important, design, because when you think about design, it touches different instances or different levels. You can redesign a product, can redesign a supply chain, make it more circular, and getting more actors in the supply chain to work on the recovery of materials, recycling or upcycling. And you can also redesign value, the value proposition, redesign the business model itself for a business model that is more sustainable based on sustainability principles. And actually companies are doing that, and academic community is trying to understand that change in the production and consumption systems we have, in all these business model innovations we have. The academic community is trying to explain those changes in different levels from a circular economy perspective, including the role of digital technologies as enablers of the circular economy systems. So it's a quite interesting dynamic emerging in the academic community in that sense.
Thank you very much. And this is all for today's episode of the International Journal of Operations and Production Management podcast series. We hope you found this discussion informative and valuable, and we'd like to thank our guest Luciano for sharing their insights and perspectives on this important topic. And a big thank you to you, our listeners, for tuning in. If you enjoyed this episode, be sure to subscribe to our podcast on your favorite platform so you'll never miss an episode. And if you have any feedback or suggestions for future episodes, we'd love to hear from you.
Finally, if you'd like to learn more about the most recent research and trends in the field of operation and production management, with a particular emphasis on the circular economy, be sure to visit the International Journal of Operation and Production Management website at www.emeraldgrouppublishing.com/journal/audiopm. There, you can read the most recent articles, submit your own research, and keep up with the latest development in the field. Particularly, if you visit issue number 4, published in 2023, you will be able to read the articles that IJPM included in the special issue, Applying Operation and Supply Chain Management Theories in the Circular Economy Context, which presents the most recent academic development in this field. Thank you for listening again, and we hope to share more insights and perspective with you in our next episode.